Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free 1 week trial. Just $4.99 a month for your all access pass. Playing now on Fandor is Miss Firecracker, starring Holly Hunter and Tim Robbins. In this film, a Mississippi girl looking for a life change decides to enter a beauty pageant. Despite a lack of support from those close to her, she remains determined. She enlists the help of a seamstress as she aims to bring home the crown.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another Fandor video podcast. My dear friend Chris Kelly is here.
Hey,
hello, Chris.
How you doing?
Bryn, and our guest, a guy named Rick Walters, who is officially 20 minutes late. Rick, what happened?
Oh, yeah.
Welcome to my world, and great first impression. First impressions, everything. Guys, I'm really honored to be here. Thank you. I am in a garden right now, and I'm going to show you guys.
Oh, cool.
Oh, nice.
Don't say cool. The guy's
I like
late.
That he's going to show us his garden, though.
Oh, look at the squirrel.
There's a squirrel. And literally, like, you see my dustpan there. I just had a major catastrophe. There's broken glass everywhere. I'm waiting.
There's
the blood
right there.
Oh, ouch.
Oh, wow.
All right. Yeah, get that.
Chris, you are so sympathetic to this guy. What the heck?
Yeah.
All right. Well, Rick.
We can live. Let's talk.
Well, there's an adorable squirrel in the shot.
Exactly.
And he cut his finger. All right, Rick. Let's
get off the hook. I'm off the hook. Thanks.
No, you're not. But that's okay. Rick, let's talk about The River. What's your movie about, and why did you choose this topic?
Well, a little bit about me first. My name's Rick. I'm 46 years old, and so I've lived a few lifetimes in those 46 years. And one of them involves some time on the streets of Portland, Vancouver, Washington, a small town named Camas that most people don't know about. But coming from Washington, you know, I'm empathetic with everything Washington. Aberdeen is kind of like the epicenter of our music culture for my generation. And so I've known about it for a long time. But I was approached by Heather Pilder Olson, who is the producer and an extremely big-hearted woman who was aware of the plight. Our executive producer, Judy Isaacson, lives in Aberdeen and has been watching these optics that everybody's been seeing.
Hold on. Tell us what's happening at the river for people who have no idea who you are or what this movie's about. The plight of what?
The plight of... So the river is the Chehalis River, which is fed by the ocean into Aberdeen, Washington. And it used to make this town a very valuable logging town. So back in the early 1900s and up to the turn of the century, you know, big money was just flowing into this town. But the logging industry died in Aberdeen, and with it, the hopes and the dreams of a lot of people there. So where the mill used to be in Chehalis is now 200, 250 people. It used to be a camp, you know, there's always 10 or 20 folks who were just passersby, maybe, but it had just kind of blown up to a point where people would cross the bridge, the 101 going into Aberdeen, and it would be a really ugly optic. Mm-hmm. So catch up to us. Heather is hearing about it from her mom. It's now become a statewide news thing and sometimes nationwide news thing when the city council started making moves to sweep the camp. In order for it to work, they needed to get together three times, and everybody nod north and south, yes, we're going to sweep the camp. And so what we did is we immediately sent stringers to start monitoring the city council meetings in order to see what was going to go on. And then we started scheduling to get ourselves there to embed with the river camp. Still with me so far?
Yeah. How big is the river camp?
And how many homeless people are there?
How many people?
There's some images we could share, but if you're looking at it from the river down, it's probably about like three football fields along the river, and it's segmented. There's the native part of it where there's just native people staying there. There's a center part where there's old timers, and then there's another part which people who are passing through. The drug culture is pretty much goes all the way up and down there both ways, but there are some people who had lived there for 17 years.
Wow.
So
how many people in total would you say are there right now currently?
There was about 250 when we went through this, according to the local police. The Aberdeen police are very helpful and useful. They're actually in our film. We wrote along with them.
So you made this movie, and it brought awareness. And I don't want you to give away the whole thing, but what has happened today to the homeless people in that community since your film has come out?
Well, you know, what we want to do, you said, raise awareness. Hopefully what this does is gives people a better look inside of it, because not a lot of people get to get very close to it. You know, they experience them from what they hear. Well, I'll go ahead and give it away. At the end of the film, the camp was swept. They actually bulldozed the thing, and all of the old structures, you know, all of the places we went inside of, and all of the people that lived there were dispersed into the city. Some of them had gone into different housing programs. Some of them had gone with families. Some of them basically just went one block up and went back to sleep there. And so it moves like that. A sweep will come, and it's kind of like a school of fish in that regard. There's the north bank and the south bank of the Chehalis. In the north bank of the Chehalis, there's like a tree fort village. It's amazing, actually. One of the girls who is primarily interviewed in the film is named Adelie. She's a young 19-year-old girl, and basically experiencing the effects of homelessness, you know, in person on the camera. You see a lot of her experience, and you hear her experience too. She's easy to relate to for anyone. We've been in touch with her. You ask what's gone on since with her grandparents, who actually saw our film on Amazon. Mm-hmm. So she reached out to us via Facebook, her grandma and grandfather, and gave us her phone number and led us to believe that she's living with a man now and doing better. We're having a screening in Aberdeen coming up, and I'm hoping she gets to come to that.
When's the screening, and is that open to the public?
Yes, it is open to the public. It's in Aberdeen, Washington.
When?
In the beautiful Grace Harbor Theater. It'll be January 14th at 7 p.m.
And okay, good.
Heather, our producer is working with Joan and you guys to make sure that we have all the information synced up too.
By the way, Joan is with Cinedime and Fandor for those of you tuning in. All right, let me ask you another question. When you look back at your movie right now, what would you have done differently if you had more money or more time?
I would have had three crews, three different camera systems going, or five if you want to include aerial and, like, you know, our little GoPro camera. I would have had a better audio presence, you know, a field mixer, and I would have stayed longer. I would have continued through more time. You know, the stories that we got to see were just the tip of the iceberg. I think the real beauty of the film, from my perspective, is the spotlight on social work and how important it is. The police in our film become social workers, and they're kind of marshalized social workers. And they have authority of the law, but more importantly, they have a rapport with and a relationship with the populations in their cities.
Yep.
This is across the country, fellas. This isn't just in Aberdeen. It's everywhere.
So this is actually an area I know a little bit about. I'm very much looking forward to, I wasn't able to see the film beforehand, but I'm very much forward to looking at it. Handmade Productions, which I'm affiliated with, we made The Tent Mender, which was about Skid Row down in downtown LA.
Very cool.
And talking about the folks on Skid Row, which is up on IMDb TV right now. Streaming.
Cool.
There. Yeah. So this is critical to capture these stories. And I'm really, really glad that you got into the camp.
So Rick, let's just, and Chris, thank you for saying that, because Chris's movie on IMDb is amazing as well. If you're
Chris,
into,
what's the title? One more time.
It's called The Tent Mender. It's a limited series, and cool. It's definitely worth your checking out.
So Rick, what are you working on now? What's next for you?
I'm currently working on locations. I'm on a TV show, Fox TV show called The Dropout. It's a miniseries. It's going to be coming out next year, but about Elizabeth Holmes.
Are you one of those actors?
That'll
be fun.
Yeah. No, I'm a location manager.
That trial is going on in San Jose right now.
It is, as you know. I got to meet her, Julie, the writer of that, and the production crew. They came on set with Hulu to do their interviews and behind the scenes stuff. Very sharp group.
Who's playing Elizabeth Holmes in that?
Amanda Seyfried.
Okay. Oh wow.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway. So let's end with this. Rick, what three films inspire you? Movies that you would like to make us aware of if they're not so popular, or three movies that you just really loved? We always like to end with this.
True Romance by Tony Scott is my favorite dark comedy.
That's a fun one.
I like Just About Everything by Paul Thomas Anderson.
Will Be Blood is his best movie.
It is.
Just
but,
so you
I'm
know.
Looking forward to his
Magnolia. Magnolia is pretty strong.
You like
strong
Magnolia?
Yeah.
I will say,
give honorable mention to Kubrick, of course. But
I will say, hold on. I will say this. You know what won me over to Paul Thomas Anderson?
What's that?
Boogie Nights.
Oh, of course. Boogie Nights. Yeah.
I mean,
that was my first taste too, and it was great.
How incredible of a movie is that?
Yeah. You don't realize until you get done and you feel the emotion that it gives you. You know, it makes you feel something, and that's what I like about it.
I'm gonna also. Punch Drunk Love is phenomenal too. I know nobody else liked it.
I liked it quite a bit. Yeah.
Okay.
Right. That's when I started liking Adam Sandler.
Yeah.
He redeemed himself with that film.
All right. What's your third?
So the documentary I was watching in eighth grade that opened me up to documentary films was Streetwise. It was made in Seattle on the streets of Seattle. It's a Verite film, and it's an impressive film. If you guys haven't seen it, it's also got Baby Gramps in it. So I played a song on this film called Slow Down that I wrote, but it was inspired by the music in that film. Baby Gramps played the Teddy Bear's Picnic down at Pike Place Market in Seattle. You should watch that. It's called Streetwise, 1980. Okay.
All right, his name is Rick Walters. His movie is The River. Rick, if people want to get in touch with you, is there a way, or are you nowhere to be found?
Please come find The River Facebook page and just talk to us there. Get on comments. I respond to them. I'm not a moderator there, but I'm an obsessive director, so I'm always on there. I'll talk to you. That's The River Documentary Film on Facebook. We're also TheRiverDocumentaryFilm.com.
Any final thoughts or...
Heather saying hi. And listen, we made this film with no politics involved. Politics kill progress. If you want to see what's going on in these homeless encampments, embed yourself.
Watch the films. And watch the films. I mean, and it's being captured well, which is super important for people to get beyond, a separation from people who are going through very difficult experiences.
Yeah.
If Chris is into your topic, that's a big deal. I just want you to know that.
I'd love to talk with you more, Chris. Sorry for being late, fellas. That's not
it's
my family.
No, it's all good.
We forgive
good.
You. Anyway, the next person we got to interview is there. So right, we wish you nothing but the best, brother.
Thanks so much,
you too,
Rick.
Fellas.
Just for you too,
have a good one.
Thanks for tuning in. Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or the app for a free 1-week trial. Playing now on Fandor is Miss Firecracker, starring Holly Hunter and Tim Robbins. In this film, a Mississippi girl looking for a life change decides to enter a beauty pageant. Despite a lack of support from those close to her, she remains determined. She enlists the help of a seamstress as she aims to bring home the crown. That's Fandor. F-A-N-D-O-R. The home for cinephiles.